at all.
It
Yeah, I
should
think
be
we're doing.
recording now.
Yeah.
It says recording on my end.
Well, Mr. Ed. Yam and Tanner here. Yam and Yanner. Just having a little sync up. Tanner is, built this super cool Arduino clock for a countdown for his birthday, which is in 9 days.
Like 9 days, like 213
31st.
hours or something like that.
So how did it start? Why'd you make it again?
Because I was surfing around the internet and I was like, what can I do with this LCD display that I have? It's just like this little like 4x4 display. And I didn't know what to do with it. And I was like, you know what? I should just put it back in my drawer. But then I found my Arduino and I was like, holy cow, I forgot that Arduinos can link up to these things. So I started doing some Googling and found an old timer that somebody had written like in 2014. It was really outdated. And the LCD library still worked. And I ran it and it was all messed up. So I fixed it, but it was still having this weird issue where it would like if you're at 200 hours, if you're at 200, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, so nothing left, you're about to go to 230 to 229. Well, what happened is minutes and seconds would go to 59, but hours wouldn't retain, it would go to something crazy like 5. So I had someone on Twitch who is a C developer refactor it for me, and it turns out I was drawing the minutes, seconds, hours in the wrong position. So we fixed that and made sure that we were still obeying logic and plugged it in, and it's still counting out there right now. Works like a charm. It is a little bit behind, like an hour and some odd minutes, but you gotta be impressed that hooking up time to an Arduino that cannot connect to the internet is pretty impressive, Sam.
It is. Yeah, it's super impressive. So, but yeah, it's good to be tech guys, you know. We just keep busy and can still hang out like this. And
Yeah.
anyways, we were thinking about you, Mr. Ed, and just wanted to say what's up, but talk to you soon.
Bye.